Hello and good afternoon everyone. As we discuss ankylosing spondylitis in the previous classes, what are the symptoms and the diagnosis and the clinical features? Today we'll discuss about the differential diagnosis and the treatment of ankylosing spondylitis. So let's recap. Ankylosing spondylitis, also known as Mary's Trumpel disease, is a seronegative spondyloarthritis of a spine and the pelvis. Ankylosing spondylitis affect the axial skeleton, usually involving the sacroiliac joints. It also affect the hip joint, knee joint, as well as your shoulder joints. All the large joint of the body is affected by the ankylosing spondylitis. Here you can see the image. There is a normal spine. Normal spine consists of a vertebra, disc, and the posterior spinous processes. So in the early ankylosing spondylitis, here you can see there is inflammatory changes as a red demarcation. You can see there is a inflammatory changes at the spine. And the advanced ankylosing spondylitis, you can see there is a fusion of the vertebrae anteriorly. So it can be developed a stiff spine or the bamboo spine, or there is a sclerotic changes here in the posterior structure. You can see the fusion at the facet joint. So these are the some changes of the ankylosing spondylitis. So today we will discuss about the differential diagnosis and the treatment of the ankylosing spondylitis. So what are the objective? Today we will discuss about the differential diagnosis, how to diagnose the ankylosing spondylitis, and how to differentiate from the other same mimic diseases, and the treatment. So let's discuss about the differential diagnosis. What are the differential diagnosis? So first one is diffuse idiopathic skeletal hyperhidrosis, so also known as DISH, D-I-S-H, or known as diffuse idiopathic skeletal hyperhidrosis. Seen in elderly people with the deposition of the calcium. Hyperhidrosis means deposition of the calcium at the joint, at the skeletal attachment of the ligament, particularly of the spine, tendons, muscle, without sacroiliacs. So DISH means deposition of the calcium at the site of enthesis. Enthesis means where your ligaments, tendons, and muscle originates, at the point of the attachment of the ligaments or the tendons. That is your DISH. And it mimic as well as the mechanical low back pain, strain, lumbosacral strain, and the sacroiliitis, and the PIVD. PIVD means prolapsed intervertebral disc, mild or multiple annular bulge. If there is a mild or multiple level annular bulge, is also differentiated with the ankylosing spondylitis, or also the TB spine. Tuberculosis of the spine also comes into different differential diagnosis of the ankylosing spondylitis. Some other differential diagnoses or DDs are degenerative disc disease. If there is a degenerative changes in the disc or the age related changes, that is your degenerative disc disease. And the herniated intervertebral disc, if your disc comes out from its original place, it's called a herniated intervertebral disc. And the fracture or the dislocation, if there is a spinal fracture, and any dislocation can cause the stiffness of the spine, there is also comes under a differential diagnosis. Osteoarthritis, if there is inflammation around the joint, or there is a spinal stenosis. Spinal stenosis means the narrowing of the central canal. And the spondylolisthesis, listhesis means the anterior slippage of the vertebra, and the spondylosis, and the reactive arthritis is it's a type of inflammation or the arthritis, and inflammatory bowel related arthritis, and the rheumatoid arthritis. So these are the differential diagnosis for the ankylosing spondylitis and the psoriatic arthritis. Now treatment methods. What are the treatment methods or the treatment tree? We include first we go for the medical management, then surgical, then physiotherapy, then other supportive measures. So first one is medical method. Medical method include the drugs. First line of drug is NSAIDs. NSAIDs means non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. The drugs which are non-steroidal in nature, but it acts as an anti-inflammatory. It relieves the inflammation because your ankylosing spondylitis is an inflammatory condition. So we have to stop the inflammation first, then we go for the further management. So there is a most important or the commonly prescribed drug in ACE is long acting preparation of the indomethacin. So first line of drug is your indomethacin. Helps to reduce the morning stiffness and pain. When the patient complains of the morning stiffness or the pain, we should go for the indomethacin. Second line of drug is sulfasalazine. That comes under the second line of drug. First, second, third, fourth means first you have to apply the or give to the patient is indomethacin, then second line means sulfasalazine, then after that so on. And third line of drug is methotrexate. When patient is not responding to NSAIDs, you can go for the DMARDs drugs. That is second line of drug. First we go for the NSAIDs, then second is go for the DMARDs. And the fourth line of drug is local corticosteroid injection. After all these NSAIDs fail, doctor prescribe the patient the corticosteroids. Then the surgeries, the different surgeries are there for joint replacement of the hip as well as knee, then vertebral wedge or spinal osteotomy. If the patient's spinal fusion, doctor can go for the vertebral wedge or spinal osteotomy, and the spinal decompression surgeries. Some spinal decompression surgery may be performed. Then correction without operation. If there is no requirement or go for the correction without operation. Elderly or those who are not fit for the major surgeries can be treated with use of external fixator, that is skeletal fixation. For example, a hallopelvic traction assembly with incorporate with a turnbuckle screw. So you can use a device or the patient can use this device, that is hallopelvic traction device, or for the low grade correction, force application or the prolonged duration. Bracing, when bracing will be used, bracing is equal to immobility. Bracing will produce the immobility, that is greater stiffness, but in the normal alignment. So that's why bracing will be used. So this is the picture of the hallopelvic traction device. Here you can see the cervical applied to the cervical spine as well as the thoracic spine. So patient is able to upright its posture. So that's why we are going to use the hallopelvic traction device for the patients. Some different types of braces are also there. There is a first one is heat and ice therapy, low back muscles wrap, and the posture corrector, upper and the shoulder support. If patient is forward bend posture, then patient can be used relief brace, back and relief brace, and the lower back pain brace. These are the braces used for the cervical, thoracic as well as the lumbar spine. Now last treatment is your physiotherapy treatment. A vital role in the symptomatic treatment, as there is no specific line of treatment available which can be modified the disease course or the progression. So we can go for the physiotherapy as well as. So treatment aim, what are the aim for the physiotherapy treatment? First we go for the control of joint pain, then maintenance of joint mobility. First we have to control the pain of the patient, then maintenance of the joint mobility, then the prevention prevention of joint deformity and the secondary complication. First, we go for the pain management. Second is joint mobility, because joint gets stiffer by day by day. So we have to maintain the mobility of joint as well, as because after that patient is not able to do any activity or any ADL activity like pumping, brushing or drinking water like that. Then the prevention of joint deformity as a secondary complication. Joint deformity means if patient goes into the hip flexion deformity or knee flexion deformity, so we have to prevent these deformity also, because after that patient is not able to walk, not able to sit. That's why we have to prevent the deformity as well. As the above all will be achieved only with the help of the well-planned exercise. So what you have to do is, first you have to well plan your exercise prescription. If you randomly select any of these exercises, patient is not able to perform or not able to understand. So according to the patient, you have to plan the exercise with the patient. Program under the supervision of the physiotherapist, which has to be followed by the patient for rest of his life once the diagnosis is confirmed. If the encouraging diagnosis is confirmed, patient have to perform these exercises for his rest of life. Thus, the disability acceptance and the patient education is important. So you have to educate the patient or counsel the patient before applying or before prescribing any of the treatment. So what are the education of the patient? First, you have to tell about his disease. Okay, what are the symptoms, what will be affect after the time, or what will be the progression of the disease. You have to tell about the disease, about the symptoms, what are the symptoms you are going to face and how it progress, and about the management, medical management or surgery or any exercise. You have to tell the patient all these management, about the importance of exercise in enclosing the spondylitis. So before going to the treatment, please discuss all the things with the patient. Then control of the pain. Superficial heating modalities, moist to hot pack. Superficial heating modalities, that is your moist hot pack. Moist hot pack is very beneficial because there is a stiff joint, so you can apply the moist hot packs during the morning or the evening sessions. And the chronic stage, deep heating modalities like SWD or the MWD. SWD is shortwave diathermy and the microwave diathermy. Other modalities like TENS, IFT and the traction can be used for the pain control. So these are the devices for the pain control. So you can go for the superficial heating modalities, then deep heating modalities, then the other modalities that improve the blood circulation as well as the neuromuscular facilitation. And the mobility, how we can mobilize the joint or mobilize the patient. To prevent the bony joint ankylosis, fibrous tissue which will be formed during the disease process are subjected to the controlled stress with the help of exercise program in order to gain mobility. And mobility exercises, exercises such as active as well as passive exercises. We can go for the active as well as patient. If patient is not able to perform the active exercise, then go for the passive. If patient is able to do active, then go for the active exercises. Then the spinal extension exercises, all the exercises which include the extension of the spine, that is your spinal extension exercises. Then spinal mobility exercises, the spinal mobilization and the self-stretching techniques. So these are the techniques you can teach the patient, or you have to discuss the patient or tell the patient to do in front of you, because if patient is do at the home, he is not able to do properly or some difficulties he face. So tell the patient to perform in front of you. These are the stretching techniques. Then treatment option according to the joint mobility scale. Joint mobility scale, these are the scale. 0 means normal, minus 1 to 3, that is abnormal. So first one is 0. 0 means no dysfunction, देर इज अ नो ट्रीटमेंट, अगर आपको कोई डिसफंक्शन नहीं है तो ट्रीटमेंट की जरूरत नहीं है. सो देर इज अ नो डिसफंक्शन नो ट्रीटमेंट. इफ माइनस वन मीन्स स्लाइटली हाइपोमोबाइल, सो यू रिक्वायर्ड मोबिलाइजेशन. माइनस टू एक्सट्रीमली हाइपोमोबाइल, दैट इज दैट रिक्वायर्ड मोबिलाइजेशन. जॉइंट एनकाइलोज्ड, एनकाइलोज मीन जॉइंट इज फ्यूज्ड, डू नॉट अटेम्प्ट टू मोबिलाइज. देन प्लस वन स्लाइट हाइपरमोबाइल, एक्सरसाइज स्प्रिंटिंग एंड द टीपी. प्लस टू एक्सट्रीमली हाइपरमोबाइल, स्प्रिंटिंग एंड प्लस थ्री दैट इज अनस्टेबल जॉइंट, सर्जरी एंड द ब्रेसिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो दीज आर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑप्शंस अकॉर्डिंग टू द जॉइंट मोबिलिटी स्केल. एंड पेशेंट में गो फॉर द हाइड्रोथेरेपी. हाइड्रोथेरेपी इम्प्रूव द स्ट्रेंथ, एंड्यूरेंस, मोबिलिटी, रिलैक्सेशन, फिटनेस, रिक्रिएशनल एक्टिविटी, पेन रिलीफ इन द वॉर्म वाटर एंड द ग्रुप थेरेपी. सो दीज आर द एक्सरसाइज पेशेंट कैन डू इन द हाइड्रोथेरेपी. स्ट्रेंथ बाय द सम स्ट्रेंथनिंग डिवाइसेस, मोबिलिटी एंड द रिलैक्सेशन कैन बी अकर एट द हाइड्रोथेरेपी. सो पेशेंट therapist must advise the patient to go for the hydrotherapy. Then posture, postural feedback, kinesthetic awareness, then correction of the faulty posture. Tell the patient to sit upright posture, don't do forward posture or don't walk in a forward stoop posture. So all these posture correction you have to tell the patient, and you go for the gait training as well as to maintain the optimal alignment of the various body segment during the sitting, standing, walking and the lying. Sleep in a firm mattress with a single pillow. Regular prone lying and the self-stretching can be taught to the patient. Then other aspects of the treatment. What are the other aspects of the treatment? There is a deep breathing exercise for the chest mobility, encourage walking and the other aerobic activities, maintain general body endurance, maintain the soft tissue stretchability, maintain a good body alignment, improve the functional capacity, yoga and the meditation. All these techniques you can teach the patient. Ankylosing spondylitis. If you have any doubt, please ask me. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.